Since antiquity, mankind has observed Mars wandering through the starry sky. After decades of spatial exploration, we now take part in a new adventure on board ExoMars 2020.
ExoMars is a space mission that will be sent to Mars in 2020. It's a joint venture between ESA, the European Space Agency, and Roscosmos, the Russian Space Agency. ExoMars consists of two elements, a surface platform and a rover that will be deposited on the surface of Mars. On the surface platform, there are several instruments. Two of them are European. One of them is LaRa. It's an instrument that is built by Belgium. And there is a whole team at the Royal Observatory of Belgium that is working on LaRa.
So LaRa is a very challenging experiment that is supposed to be landing on Mars in the 2021. Why is it so challenging? First, because it has to land on Mars, which is pretty difficult. I have to recall that we never succeeded here in Europe to land on Mars, so it's going to be a first one. Second, LaRa is a very small box, a very small instrument, big like a shoebox, using only a few amount of power, something like what consume your lightning bulb. Using this amount of power, it will be able to communicate directly from Mars to the Earth, so over something like 350 million of kilometers. So it's very challenging for this, and also challenging because using this and using the principle of Doppler shift, we are going to locate at the surface of Mars this little box with a precision or an accuracy which is something like 10 centimeters or something like that.
The measurement principle of LaRa is rather simple. LaRa returns radio signals that it receives from big telescopes on Earth back to Earth. And on Earth, we will then measure how this radio signal has changed. In particular, we look at how the frequency has changed. That is what we call Doppler shift. And the Doppler shift is rather familiar to most of us. For example, when you hear a train arriving and afterwards leaving, its tone will change. And this is related to the difference in velocity of the train with respect to us. And in the same way, we will use the Doppler shift to learn about how LaRa moves with respect to the Earth. And since LaRa is fixed to the surface of Mars, we can learn how Mars rotates. And in fact, that is very important because it will learn us about the interior of Mars. Now, Mars rotates in about 24 hours around its axis, about the same as the Earth. But it's not always constant. Sometimes the rotation is a bit faster, sometimes the rotation is a bit slower. And also, it performs a wobbly motion in space. It performs, in fact, a large circle in a very long timescale, in about 170,000 years. And on top of this circular motion, which is called precession, there are small wiggles, which we call nutation. And both of them, nutation and precession, will learn us about the deep interior of Mars. So it will tell us, for example, how large the core of Mars is. The core of Mars is mainly composed of iron, but we do not know exactly what other elements are there. And this is something that LaRa will help to answer. And it will also explain to us whether the core is liquid or not. We think it is liquid, but LaRa will confirm whether this is liquid. And all these things about the interior of Mars are very important to learn how Mars formed and how Mars evolved.
Habitability is commonly understood as the potential of an environment to sustain life. There are three conditions: energy, nutrients, and liquid water. In order to have liquid water at the surface of Mars, we need to understand the evolution of the planet and the evolution of all the reservoirs. Therefore, the instrument LaRa.